the 23rd annual Kennedy Center Honors, honoring Mikhail Baryshnikov, Chuck Berry, Placido Domingo, Clint Eastwood, Angela Lansbury. Ladies and gentlemen, Walter Cronkite.
Good evening and welcome to this 23rd Kennedy Center Honors. The spirit that surrounds this national celebration of the arts was expressed by a great American president half a century ago in the shadow of World War II. Franklin Delano Roosevelt said, "The arts cannot thrive except where men are free to be themselves and to be in charge of the discipline of their own energies and ardor." Behind me on our signature wall here are the names of those who have gone before. Tonight, we add the names of five artists to our roll of honor here. Consider their origins and the different paths they have taken to bring them here together tonight. A little kid who started in St. Louis with a four-string guitar and duck-walked his way into a rockin' place in musical history. A golden tenor born in Madrid who made the world his stage and gave opera a new word, superstar. A plucky gal from London who crossed the pond and found the highlands of film, theater, and television. An actor from Oakland, California, who decided that less was more and earned a fistful of success. A boy wonder from Riga, Latvia, whose bold leap to freedom led him to a new country and let him dance as no one else has, before or since.
Gregory Hines.
Knowing Mikhail Baryshnikov as I do, I know how difficult it's going to be for him to sit there and listen to us heap praise upon him. And that's what we're going to do, Mike. We're going to give you a real good going over. Many times since we worked together, I've tried to tell him just how much I appreciate his generosity as a dancer and as an actor. And he won't sit still. He always runs away. And I chase him. I remember the first time we danced together. We were going to do a movie called White Nights. And I remember that first day we went into the rehearsal studio. And he couldn't get out of my way. I stepped on his toes and I crashed into him. And I remember that first time we jumped up in the air together and I came down. And then he came down. You just have that skill, Mike, I know you're doing choreography, and I guess most people know you're doing choreography, but it looks like you're just making it up. It looks like you're just doing it. It's like Lenny Bruce used to say, to do a routine hundreds of times and give it the illusion of the first moment. You can really do that. I've seen you dance so many times, and you can just make it look like you're just doing it for the first time. You're an amazing dancer, an amazing human being. And I know how difficult the decision it was for you to come here to America. I know that. But I know that I can speak for everyone in America who's ever seen you dance when I tell you that we are just so happy that you did come here.
In Riga, the journey began. Already someone special, they sent him to Leningrad to Alexander Pushkin. From his class came the great stars of the Kirov Ballet. It was never about how high or how grand, but about the inner life, about creating a character. In Russia, where the classics were revered, Misha was their white knight. When he had done all there was to do, he asked for something more. So began the tug of war between star and state, between what he had been and what he might become. The West gasped. Baryshnikov was coming to dance for us. Here, the journey picks up speed, forward to the next horizon. Where could dance take him now? To Twyla Tharp, iconoclast and wit, in a dance for him she called Push Comes to Shove. He went after the risk-takers and the rebels. Martha Graham. Paul Taylor. And Merce Cunningham, father figure of the avant-garde. Misha said, new dances, new people, new life. Jerome Robbins answered. And then George Balanchine, who left Russia a half a century earlier to remake ballet in America. Their time was short, but it bestowed a kind of blessing, a devotion to this art, and the passion to create what is fresh, what is human, what is astonishing. He is a man in perpetual motion. The joy of watching is not knowing where he'll go next. To his own company, where dancers and choreographers begin, at the place where the others left off. There is nothing fancy anymore. There is only space. His body and his spirit, when he dances to the beat of his own heart. Some journey.
There's nothing shaking come this here July. I'm gonna roll myself up in a big ball and die.
No dancer has ever made so much of freedom.
A special tribute to Mikhail Baryshnikov when the Kennedy Center Honors returns. The Kennedy Center Honors, a celebration of the performing arts, sponsored by the men and a celebration of the performing arts, sponsored by the men and women of General Motors, whose commitment Mark Morris.
Mikhail Baryshnikov has changed dance forever. Technically, artistically, and in every way that one can imagine. Mikhail Baryshnikov has changed me forever, too, with his friendship and dedication to my work and my company over the years. Misha, darling, the members of the Mark Morris Dance Group adore you, and so tonight we have come here to honor you with a dance to Lou Harrison's music we call Polka. Thank you.
of dance salutes Mikhail Baryshnikov. Misha's first partner at ABT, Natalia Makarova. A partner from the New York City Ballet, Patricia McBride. From Misha's White Oak Company, Rob Besser. His colleague, Trisha Brown. ...1996 Kennedy Center honoree, Maria Tolchi. 1997 honoree, Edward Villela. 1995 honoree, Jacques D'Amboise. 1993 honoree, Arthur Mitchell. 1999 honoree, Judith Jamison. And Gregory Hines. Kennedy Center Honors, a celebration of the performing arts, sponsored by Schweppes and your local Schweppes bottler.